actually, I'm here from the start. I was here from the moment that there came a big crane to put all the boats on the mainland, and I was filming that. And then it felt like home immediately.
We now work in like ships, but on the ground.
And nobody could still see that this would actually be paradise. And after 2 months, everybody said, yeah, I knew it, this will be the perfect spot.
A lot of people think, like, because it's such a small city, that's why we bike. But it's actually an active plan by the citizens. So the whole north, we don't even have a bridge. It's because it was basically not part of the city until like 5 years ago, at least in the mind of the people from the center. So you still have to go with the ferry to go to the other way, because it was more like old industrial site. But then in the 80s, with economic downturn and the selling of these, well, for instance, the shipyards, and the city center basically just left the north a little bit to rot, which was super sad. And only now in the next, yeah, like the past 10 years, that's really changing. This is the Keuvel. We're now in the Buiksloterham area in the north of Amsterdam, which primarily used to be an old industrial site. When the crisis hit, it was a big question, like, what can we do with this land? So there was a tender set out by the municipality to basically come up with the best idea to figure out for a brownfield like this one, to come up with a 10-year plan to build something cool, sustainable. And yeah, we won that tender. We chose to use a lot of recycled materials, second-hand houseboats, but also looking at all sorts of innovations on the water level, trying to figure out best ways to come up with energy innovations, and also food production, urban farming and such. So on all these levels, we came up with a plan and we've introduced all of them. Why pay for energy from somebody else if you can be your own producer of energy? Well, basically, we're systems thinkers. So we try to look at the whole system and come up with innovations to change that system. The water, so that you can see it cycling, goes up and it basically goes down like a waterfall. It's growing really quickly. We planted these, I think, 2 weeks ago. And we did it together with a lot of a group of people. So we really want to do it in an educational fashion. The panels, they open automatically based on the amount of heat.
Yeah, well, basically we're trying to close all the loops, both on the energy level, as in on the waste level. We're trying to be a blueprint for a new reality, for a possible reality. It's not that we're making like a big change here with a big impact for the whole of Amsterdam or the Netherlands or Europe, but we try to be an example so you can have a stepping stone effect, a butterfly effect. So we're just showing another way, we're showing an alternative. That's basically what we do.
So we have two smart meters, one which is measuring the complete consumption of the cafe. But it also runs the blockchain software, which enables it to actually make transactions.
Well, here our local grid has 15 houseboats connected to it. Almost all of them have solar power PV panels on top of them. And they are able to then trade the energy. And here you can see basically the map of the Keuvel as it's running now. And you can see with each boat the actual consumption at the moment and the production. The cafe is now consuming 9,000 something and only producing 1,800. So we have our own microgrid here at the Keuvel. And that means that we are able to send tokens of energy through a blockchain towards each other. And this value transaction, we actually are also able to gain something through that. So if I send, for instance, my energy tokens towards the cafe, is that I can go to the cafe and buy a cup of coffee with that, or a beer, or something to eat.
For the 18 actors that are here, blockchain doesn't really make so much sense. But with the idea of scaling it up to an infinite number of actors on the same grid, it really does make sense. Because you can have any number of actors on a decentralized network, and you can perform transactions without having to know each other.
But also, a large part of the Keuvel specifically is to inspire others and to really get other people to act differently. So we host information nights, documentary nights, you name it. Or for instance, what we're having this weekend is a Make the World Great Again festival, which is completely geared to making a positive impact by actually changing your behavior on a festival. So during the festival, you can change from a dirty bank to a green bank.